Hi folks. Well, we're on the second leg of the journey, and that's the hookup. We've got the platform built temporarily. We're going to, before we lay the tile, we're going to lay the tile later when it's warmer. That way there's no issue of cracking or anything like that. So for now we're going to put our fiber rock on the back side, and then we're connecting the chimney. So the chimney is double wall. Now we're going to single wall. I want single wall just so we get the heat out of the pipe. And it all gets screwed together with three or four screws. Now, what I'm going to do is this. Some people suggest to get collapsible, adjustable sections of pipe. Well, I agree with that. That's the easy way. Or you can buy one of these guys for like, I don't know. I think it was like 15 bucks. Sheet metal shears at I think they were Harbor Freight, and I tell you, I've already saved the money on this section of pipe right here. I cut it to size, and then this section of pipe I measured all the way around, and you can see my line right there, and I'm going to cut along that line with the sheet metal shears. There you go, now I've got a cut. I wonder if I can do this. Cheat the system a little bit. Instead of using a hacksaw, I'll use my head. Now this is a pretty... This took me 5 minutes to do this. Now I just saved another, I don't know. Well, the pipe was $5. An adjustable one like this would be $35, so I just saved $30. Not too bad for 5 minutes. Now we're good to go. Just so you know, when you see a piece of pipe, the way it works is the crimped edge always points down. So whenever you're doing a pipe, sometimes you ask, well, the crimped edge always points to the stove. So that's just an easy way to remember it. All right, here we go. Here comes the hookup. All hooked and ready to go. Hey folks, we have our chimney in. It's screwed together with the screws. Now we're adding the fire brick. So what we do is, the best thing for ash is, not hot ash, but cold, is to take, we've got a rainbow vac. And what that is a vacuum cleaner with a water filter in the bottom. So we turn it on, and vacuum all that excess junk out of there. You've got the flue control right there. You've also got the air control right here. If you notice, it goes from big to little. Simple, but yet it works. It just opens up some holes to let it breathe more, and then your fire gets hotter and hotter. We've got this temperature gauge, and we're running good and hot right now.
And we got fire.
It's up and going. Our little magic heat just turned on. There you go. Now I have my alternative heat source. But it's working beautifully. We're very, very pleased. And it's putting out a lot of nice heat.